Just making a quick video today to show you a few things. I know I don't make a lot of videos, and you know, guys always showing everybody what they're using for the season and whatnot. I just figured I'd give you a little update, a few tips I got here on my setup for this year. Yeah, a couple of bows set up. First of all, I got my recurve that I'm going to be using. It's a nice takedown recurve bow. Beautiful wood. And it's actually a top archery Korean bow. And I've got three or four custom bows, and I love them. But this here just caught my eye, and it's kind of neat. I picked it up, and it's a nice shooter. I put the limb bolts on there, as you can see, and attached one of the old 1950 Bear quivers on it. Fits right under the limb bolts with a hole drilled in there for an attachment. Works out great. Carries 4 arrows, and I can always put an adapter, you know, one of these piggybackers, and carry a blunt with me. So for that, I'm probably going to use most of the season. I got it coupled with some 1916 arrows, and get that out of the way. 1916 arrows, and with this bow, I've got Magnus stingers. I mean, these darn things are sharp, and I've got them real sharp. And they got that bleeder blade in there, which I happen to like. Sometimes I don't use a bleeder blade, but makes a nice cut. So that's what I'm using for this bow. And what I just worked on a little bit is getting my Montana longbow back in action. And I haven't used it for 2 years ago. I used it, killed a couple of does with it, which was great. I had a great time. And but I wasn't having good arrow flight from the arrows I had, so I had to work on that a little bit. And long story short, as I came up with using the same 1916 arrows for this bow, this is a 50-pound longbow, and Bear razor heads. And these are just, you know, regular, about 125 and 130 grain razor heads. You know, they always work. And I've got those set up with this bow. Same thing, I have a 1950s quiver, and that's got the rubber straps from Great Northern that I attached to that, and it works out good. But what I wanted to show you guys is a I hunt a lot, and I beat up my bows, and I just do. Like you guys, we go into the woods and beat them up. So I repainted this bow again, and still I want to put a cover on it. So I'm using this nice camo tape. I have it on this bow, and I have it on the recurve that I just showed you. And basically, what it is, simple old duct tape from Walmart, I think. And it comes in a roll. It's cheaper than anything else I've ever found. It works out good. Now, I know in this light it kind of shines, but it does not really shine in the woods at all. It's pretty darn nice, and it's strong. Yeah, it leaves residue if you take it off, but you can take the residue off with some goop or goo gone or goof off or whatever you can use for that. But if you're going to leave it on the bow, it's fine, and it takes a good beating, and that's good. And I happen to like it. Put that there. Another thing is, I want to show you, I've been working on some tabs. I make some simple tabs. I make 3 or 4, and they last forever. You know, I got a pattern that I use. I cut it out. I use 2 or 3 layers, as you can see, of deer skin, regular deer skin. That's all it is. One happens to be dyed a different color, and they work great. They're fine. I use them a lot. Okay. very simple. And they can be made yourself. It's you can make them. You can do it. Just get some leather, make a pattern, or get a pattern, or find a tab that you happen to like and make trace that pattern and cut it out little by little. You need some sewing skills maybe, but you don't even need that. If you don't want to, you could take three layers and glue them together. But it works great. something else I want to show everybody is this old K-bar knife. This is a treasure that I have. It's actually got a bone handle, pommel on it, rather. Bone pommel. And it's black and yellow handle. And it's a K-bar. It says it right on there. K-bar. I don't know if you can see that. Union Cutlery, Olean, New York. It's a little knife. That's it. I'm sure some of the blade is gone now from sharpening over the years, but I got this from my great-grandfather when he visited his relatives out in Colorado in the 1940s. They took a trip out there, and this was given to him by a fella that lived out there, and he had it for I don't know how long, and he was a neat hunter, that old guy. Stories I heard, he'd go to, after summer work, he would go up to the mountains in the fall. Him and his wife would live there for months at a time, get their meat, cool it in a stream. He was a real outdoorsman. But he gave my grandfather that knife, my great-grandfather that knife. And, you know, it was passed on to me from him. And it's just, I use it very little. I use it very little. But I thought it was a neat knife to show everybody. If anybody knows or has any more information on that, let me know. Just send me an email or whatnot. Okay? But I thought it was a pretty cool knife. So, anyway, that's it. Just a quick show of the two bows I'm going to use. They're arrows. And I said about that duct tape and get that at Walmart. Or, you know, paint it if you need to in a dull camo if you want to do that. But the paint comes, you know, has a little more harder time getting off. The tape you could take right off. So, anyway, good luck this season. Patronize your traditional archery suppliers and your local and national traditional bow hunting organizations. That's important. Let's keep the tradition going. Okay? See you soon.